2024, June 23rd. This video is about difference between Jalan Gam and Locust Bin Gam, how they differ in their effect, not in their chemical structure, but in their felt effect. So the Locust Bin Gam gives you sheep shit. You shit like a sheep. It gives you this small your shit is composed of like small balls, like sheep do, and they stick to each other, and by doing so they give you a blockage of the bowel, and the only and constipation, and in the longer term diverticulosis. The only good thing about this is that when you wipe the sheep shit, you have very, very little to wipe. You have very little work. This is the only good thing about it, but it is very bad, because constipation is very bad, and this gives you quite bad constipation. And Jalan Gam, it sticks so hard, it really gives you a one piece blockage in a certain milk based beverage. It is not really milk based, it contains very little milk. It is a milk product. It only contains a little amount of milk, so it is unfair to call it even a milk product. It is a Jalan Gam based product with a little milk to be considered a milk product, and such products give milk a bad name. So in a certain Jalan Gam based beverage, the beverage sticks so much, so hard to the plastic bottle that it cannot be fully emptied. Not if you shake it before you drink it, and not if not. It sticks so hard to the bottle, you have to throw it. You have to throw part of what you bought, because you cannot consume it. And this is the only good thing about this certain beverage. Of course, if it contained less Jalan Gam, it may have been fully drinkable. But it does not. And Jalan Gam does not give you sheep shit. It gives you, as I said, a full blockage. It does to your colon the same thing that it does with that bottle. You can see how it sticks to the smooth plastic bottle. It does the same with your colon. It it sure causes you to bleed, and so I can differentiate and say, well, Jalan gum is worse even than locust bean gum. It gives you an even harder constipation, and I do not remember that it had that good effect of little work to wipe, which is still not worth it because of the bad constipation that locust bean gum will give you. But Jalan makes it even worse. It is not just hard constipation, it also sticks so hard to your colon. It will make you bleed. It does makes you bleed if you consume it by an error or by wanting to try it. So the number one worst food ingredient, if it can be called food, is Jalan gum. The number two is locust bean gum, and the number three is carrageenan. Carrageenan does not give you constipation, as far as I can recall. But it gives you bloody leakage without constipation. You wipe, you see blood. This is from carrageenan. Not anywhere near as bad as even locust bean gum. Carrageenan, by the way, I read that what I said so far is only based on experience. Nothing that I heard or saw or read, I based what I say about this thing so far. Now I am going to say something which I read, so I say it explicitly. This is not from experience what I will say from now. I read that it causes, carrageenan causes, how was it called? Death of the colon of infants. There is a more scientific word for it. What was the word? The Latin word. Atrophy, I think. Atrophy or something even worse than atrophy. Something even worse, not simple atrophy. Even necrosis, not just atrophy. Necrosis of the colon in infants. And why would it not do the same with grown people? I do not know. It was only written about infants. I know from experience it causes a bloody leakage in fully grown people. And so the number one worst stabilizer or whatever it is called is Jalan gum. The number two worst is locust bean gum. The number three worst is Karaginan, and the number four worst out of those which I experienced is Guargam, which gives you a lot to wipe. When you consume Guargam, the whatever it was added to is usually not very tasty. It is like, I do not know how it gives it a texture, a certain texture, because of whatever they removed from the artificial industrial food, and by trying to compensate for the good stuff which they removed, they add the guar gum, which is and it does not turn to be very tasty then, and it gives you a lot to wipe when you wipe, and but it does not give you a hard constipation, and I do not recall that it gives you a bloody leakage, and nothing near as bad as the Jalan gum. So guar gum, I would say, is the fourth worst. And I did try other stabilizers besides of these four, but I just do not recall enough to about any of them to say that it caused anything as distinguished as bad as these four. But I also did not try other stabilizers often enough to base an opinion on their effect. So this is it for the video, which was about difference between the effects of four of stabilizers, and ranking them from worst to the least out of the four least bad.